In this video, I want to show you how you can remove the background from a photo and then save it so that you can use it afterwards just as a PNG, so it has a transparent background, and then you can just add your own background. And then also I'll show you how to save all the layers. We're going to add a few layers in this video, and then how we merge them all just to save one single photo with all the layers. So I'm going to show you that right now. So once you have the photo that you want to use, I just like to always make a duplicate just in case something happens. So right click and choose duplicate, and then turn that back main background layer off. So we're just going to work with the copy. And now I'm going to remove the background. So I'm going to choose the magic wand tool. And it's picking up some areas in her face just because there's so many different variations of blue in this image, and I've already played around with the tolerance, so this is a pretty good selection. So to remove these selections around her face and a little bit down on her back here, I'm going to come up to the ellipse selection, and now with the subtract from selection, I'm just going to make some selections, elliptical selections on her face and down on her back here. And now I'm going to switch to the smart brush selection. So just click that and select the subtract from selection. Every time you switch a tool here, so if you were using the subtract from selection and then all of a sudden you switch to another tool, it will switch back to the add to selection. These two, because they're both the brush, they don't switch around, but any other tool will. So let's go back to the smart selection, smart brush, and choose subtract from selection, and then just click and push, and it automatically detects the edges. And you probably can't see this down here in the video, but it is not completely lined up. I wanted to go over to her hair here. It's hard to see. Okay, so that looks good. I'm going to go ahead and delete the selection. And now we have a transparent background. So clear the selection, and now to save this, we just want to come up here to File, Save as a New Photo File, and then wherever your destination folder is, just if it defaulted, then that's great. If not, then click this to change it. And so I would put it on here, and then images. I've already saved it. I called it Pretty Woman Cutout. So I'm not going to save it again, but that's what you would do. And you would save it as a PNG. And let's just double click that folder. Okay. So right here is where you would save it as a PNG. So once it's done exporting, we can now add a new background layer. So come down here to the main background layer, the one that we turned off, and let's add a new background layer. So this is something new that's in Photo Director 10. So come over here to Add New Layer. And in Photo Director 10, we can add a solid color layer. And we can choose any of the basic colors down here, or if we move our cursor around the image, it changes into an eyedropper, and you can choose any shade from wherever you want, and then just click on to the background. Whoops, you gotta say okay. There we go. Or we can choose a bunch of different backgrounds, so you can test different ones out. So let's add another one. So just repeat the process, add new layer, add solid color layer, and then let's choose a pink one. And so if you turn the pink one off, you can see that one below. And if we turn them both off, we're back to our transparent background. So now I want to show you, actually I'll leave these off. I'm going to go down to the photo viewer and let's add another image as a background. So I'm just going to scroll over and find something else. So I'm going to click on this image. Don't click on it yet because it'll click to that image and you'll lose the image that you're working on. You need to click and drag on the image that you want to bring up. And I want to put it underneath the woman background, the cutout of the woman. And it is a different size. So I'm just going to turn the image off of the woman. And I'm going to come over here while I'm on that layer. The layer is called Men at Window. And with the pick and move tool selected, I'm just going to click and drag and make that image bigger. This won't work for all images, but I really am not concerned about this one. So I'm just gonna go like that, and then I'm gonna turn that top layer back on. So there's the image of the woman. And now let's go to our pick and move tool, and you can just move her around. Now I wanna put her so that she's behind the two men. So I'm going to change the blending mode to multiply. Now it looks like they're looking out at her. I don't know, maybe it's a giant billboard or something. But so that's how you do that. And now I'm just going to add, an express template. And in Photo Director 10, they have a bunch of new templates that you can purchase. And I haven't purchased any of them, but that's something that's new. So click on that. And if you've created any Express templates in the past, they'll be here under My Creations. And I've created a bunch, so I'm just going to click on My Creations and then just scroll down until you find the one that you want. And I want to add this sun flare. So double click, and there, it just brings it in. And then you can just move that around wherever you want it. Move it over here. We can flip it if we want so that it's coming from the opposite corner. So click, flip layer horizontally, and then just move that however you want it. Wherever you want it. You can change the blending mode. I'm going to move it, flip it back. I'm just going to put it up in that corner. The best blending mode is the screen or the overlay, but that makes it kind of dark. Color dodge. I'll keep it on screen. So now I'm going to show you how you would combine these and export it as one image. So with all the layers that you want included, make sure they're turned on. And we can merge these if you want to. Or if you want to come back to this project at a later time and work on the individual layers again, like maybe you want to turn this layer off and you want to have a solid color background or a different color. In that case, I wouldn't merge the layers. I would just leave it like this. And I would save this as a Photo Director layer file. And it has the .phi extension. So that'll allow you to come back and edit each individual layer. Or we can save it as a new photo file right from here without merging it. We don't need to merge them. So it's just when you merge it, it compresses the file size, so it just saves you a little space. So I'm just going to choose Save as a New Photo File. And you can save it as a PNG if you want. It's not, we don't have any transparency that we want to save. So we can, to reduce the file size, we can just change it to a JPEG. And then if you want to resize it and make the file smaller, you can do that if you have a size in mind. But I'm just going to keep the original photo resolution and click export. And now I'm going to go to those two files that we saved, and I just want to show you each one. So here's where I saved them in images, and there's the PNG that I had saved earlier. I guess I saved it twice. And let me just double click it. So you can't tell that it's a PNG, but it is. So if you wanted to put it on a website with no background, just the image of the woman, then that would be transparent. And then here's the image with all the layers as a JPEG. So if we go back to our image, let's try a different background. So I'm going to use this kid standing at the chalkboard. So I'm going to click and drag, and I'm going to put that underneath the woman. And then I'm going to turn off that lens flare layer. And then I'm going to go on the layer of the woman and move her over. Resize her a little bit. And we can change the blending mode of the woman if we wanted to. I'm going to leave it at multiply, and I'm going to duplicate the layer of the woman and make her black and white. So right click and duplicate, and then turn that layer, the original layer of her, off. Go on the duplicate, and then come over here to the adjust layer. And then take your saturation slider all the way to the left. And that makes it black and white. And then you can play with the opacity here if you want. Change the opacity. And then again, if you wanted to export this, you would just do the same thing again. Come up here, go to File, Save as a New Photo File. And then just save it, rename it, whatever you want to rename it, and then click export. So there's a lot of different things you can do to get creative. And I will be making more videos to show you how you can get more creative. And I'm also working on a course. So I'm going to break it down into sections. I'm not going to do it all in one video. I'm going to have all different courses, and I'm working on that, so I hope to have that done soon. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you haven't already subscribed, please go ahead and subscribe, and thanks for watching.